science explorers, it's Justin again. Today is our last day filming in the forest, and it is freezing. I know all of the warm-blooded animals are safe and sound, but we haven't seen any cold-blooded creatures since the seasons changed. I have a feeling we'll need to dig deep to find where reptiles, amphibians, and fish are hiding out for the winter. Let's go on one last journey in the forest to find out how cold-blooded animals survive the winter. We've seen how some warm-blooded animals can withstand the cold weather while others migrate or go dormant for the winter. But cold-blooded animals have some added challenges to face when the temperature drops. What do you think some of these cold weather conundrums might be? Pause the video now and in your field notes, write down what you remember about cold-blooded animals and what they might be worried about as winter comes. The body temperature of cold-blooded animals changes with the temperature of their environment. So if it's freezing in the forest, they're probably freezing too, unless they find a way to shield themselves from the cold. This freshwater pond is starting to freeze over, but let's see if we can find any reptiles or amphibians that are still around. Mia, zoom in here. I think I spotted something. Ah, finally, a sign of life. Looks like this reptile is trying to catch as many minnows as it can. Does this remind you of any other animal behavior? Right, just like warm-blooded animals, cold-blooded ones try to get in as much food as they can before the weather gets too cold. Though instead of storing fat, these animals store sugar and other minerals from their food to help keep their bodies from freezing with the cold temperatures. How do you think this little guy knows that winter is coming? Do you remember what triggers plants and warm-blooded animals to start preparing for winter? Right, they notice when the days start getting shorter. So, what change in the environment do you think triggers reptiles, amphibians, and fish to start preparing for winter? Yep, they notice when the temperature begins to drop in the fall, since warmth is so important to their survival. I think I could spot another turtle shell over there by the edge of the pond. Do you see it, Mia? Yes, it is a turtle! Hey, does this remind you of another creature that we saw burrowing in the forest floor? Right, it's buried in the leaves like the hedgehog. I remember that the hedgehog was hibernating. Mia, do reptiles like this turtle hibernate too? No? So, what type of dormancy or winter rest do reptiles experience in the winter? Ah, brumation. This is a type of dormancy just for cold-blooded animals. Brumation is a lot like torpor. The animals wake up occasionally to catch some sun or a snack. Animals that brumate have a slowed heart rate and metabolism, just like those that hibernate or go into torpor. Their body temperature drops too. But because they're cold-blooded, this happens before their dormancy. What other animals do you think are brumating around the forest? Ooh, I think I see something in the mud over there. A toad! Like turtles, these guys are good at digging, and they burrow into the mud around or at the bottom of ponds to brumate. This amphibian is buried pretty deep in the wet soil. How do you think it breathes under all that mud? Think back to what we know about amphibians and the forest floor. And in your field notes, describe how toads might be able to breathe while brumating underground. Take your time. We'll go over the answer when you get back. Amphibians have the ability to absorb the oxygen from water through their skin. They usually use this while swimming, but the mud near freshwater holds plenty of moisture too. So this toad can breathe just fine while the wet soil covers its body. Turtles are reptiles, but they're gifted with a similar amphibian-like ability to absorb oxygen from the water. But what about reptiles that can't do this? How do they stay warm? Ooh, do you see that snake peering out from a den in the rocks? I wonder if we can get a look inside. Mia, do you Some reptiles find a nest or den to protect themselves from the cold. This nest, or hibernaculum, is shared by dozens of other snakes, which allows them to share body heat while they brumate. They'll wrap their long, scaly bodies around each other in here to keep warm, and leave every so often when temperatures rise to warm up and catch some food. Okay, what do you say we move on to something less creepy-crawly? Let's keep moving. There's one last kind of cold-blooded animal that we haven't checked in on. Fish. The pond over here looks frozen solid. Do you think the fish are frozen too? Mia, is there any way you can... Yeah, thank you. Oh, look! The fish are safe and sound under the ice. When the pond freezes over, they go into a light state of dormancy where they move and eat less than usual. They'll also start moving as usual again when the pond ice melts with the sun's warmth in the spring. Wow, since we've been exploring the forest, we have learned so much about how different plants and animals survive the cold. And we couldn't have done it without your help, so thank you for coming along with us. I don't know about you, Mia, but I think I'm ready for a winter getaway. What do you say we take this film crew to somewhere warmer? We have to travel a long way to explore our next destination. Come with us to explore how animals adapt to live in a very different type of biome, the grasslands. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey, hey!